Listed in the description of this video is a link to a video on Twitter. It's a long video, and while I remain unconvinced that the incidence of ALS is increasing, this video drives home the point that ALS can strike any age. Grandparents, parents, college students, high schoolers, and even little kids. Did you know that little kids get ALS? In its industry guidance for ALS, the FDA promised to treat ALS with regulatory flexibility so that patients would receive access to therapies that reduce the rate of progression, like Amylyx. I am grateful for their exercise of regulatory flexibility with this drug. When the FDA was provided such an opportunity to show flexibility with NurOwn, the most clinically promising therapy to date, they have chosen not to because they rely on a highly subjective means of measurement, the ALSFRS score, a rating of loss of appraised function instead of measuring clinically relevant biomarkers. To put it in perspective, it would be like testing the function of a cancer drug by measuring whether a cancer patient is able to walk unassisted instead of measuring blood biomarkers. In cancer, such a practice would be laughable. In ALS, it's industry standard. In ALS, because we don't understand the etiology of the disease, our knowledge of which biomarkers to measure is restricted to more general markers, such as neuroprotective and anti-inflammatory markers. NurOwn has already demonstrated outstanding performance in those areas in its Phase 3 trial. Yet the FDA continues to prefer reliance on the antiquated ALSFRS score. What will it take to shift the FDA away from the outdated ALSFRS score? What will it take to get the FDA to keep their word by extending regulatory flexibility to NurOwn? How many more grandfathers, moms, and kids need to die first?